start off with a scenario. A person walking down the street, when passing a rather shady alleyway. Now, how many of us have passed shady alleyways while walking down the street? I know I have. When passing a rather shady alleyway, this person sees someone getting mugged by a group of people. The person then quickly walks away so as not to be seen by the assaulters. And this person also made note of the street the assault was happening on. Let me ask this question. What should this person do next? Pray. Pray. Anyone else?
Call the police.
Let me set up another scenario. Every day, a manager sees young people working hard at their place of employment. Some of these hard-working young people have gone on to get promotions, and some have even gone on to start their own businesses. One day, this person enters into the break room for lunch. How many of you have entered into the break room for lunch? I know I have. Oh, yeah. And when they walk in, this person walks in. He walks in on a conversation about how today's young adults are lazy, selfish, and unmotivated. That they don't want to work, and that this country is heading for trouble when they're in position to lead it. Let me ask you, what should this manager do? Anybody? Say some good things that the young people are doing. Anything else?
Embrace it.
What's that?
Embrace it.
Embrace what they're saying?
Embrace it not.
Oh. Embrace the youth, you mean, that are being talked down about. Amen. In such scenarios, being a witness is vital. We know how important it is for criminal investigations that there be witnesses of crimes who are willing to risk their lives and their necks to report them. And oftentimes, police will put out bounties to get people to witness to crimes because people are so afraid to do so. But we know how vital and important it is to criminal investigations that there be witnesses. We also know that when you witness something that counters what people are claiming, we call that in today's time fact-checking, right? But we know that when you witness something that counters what people are claiming, it is important to be a witness to the truth and to set the record straight. Or in the case of the scenario, at least caution people not to overgeneralize. Yet as Christians, we tend to tone down our witness. Or worse, we don't witness at all. We may say, oh, on Sunday I can't do that because I go to church, maybe in the afternoon, and that's it, right? Like, we don't go beyond that. Now, this was not always the case. Otherwise, we would not be sitting here discussing Christianity at all. In fact, my ancestors would be dancing around some fire in Germania, Ireland, England, and Scotland to God knows what gods. We are Christians solely because of Christian witness. Amen? How many of you have, well, this is a serious question. How many of you have Jewish ancestry? Okay. So I think it's then safe to say that not, oh, did somebody raise their hand? If somebody raised their hand, awesome. Other than that, I would say it's safe to say that none of us have a heritage that leads us back to Jesus Christ, amen? And none of us, we're certainly living, even if we do have that lineage, we're certainly not living in a time where we would have known Jesus personally as he was walking and teaching his disciples, amen? We weren't I hear some laughter. Some of us may feel that old, but we're not. And I would say that it's safe to say that none of us were physically present to witness the death or the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Amen? Okay. So that means that all of us would not be Christian if it were not for Christian witness. This was not always the case, that we would hide our Christian witness and do nothing to witness to Jesus Christ. In fact, I would say that the earliest Christians who started the Christian witness, the ones who did physically resurrect, or physically see Jesus resurrect from the dead, and physically ate with him and talked with him and witnessed his resurrection and physically saw him ascend to heaven, they were so sure, and the ones who followed them were so sure, and the ones who followed them were so sure that they witnessed the resurrected Lord that they went to their deaths witnessing to that very fact. Now, there are a lot of things I think are cool out in the world. I love Greek mythology, right? Hercules is awesome. But I would not die or risk my life to find the seven-headed Hydra and fight it. Just wouldn't. I don't know if any of you are out there. My apologies, but I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't die, even though he's a real person who really lived in history, and I find the movie Braveheart intriguing, I wouldn't die for William Wallace. Or at least the Mel Gibson version of it. Right? But these people were willing to die in order to witness to what they saw, to what they believed at their core to be true. By the way, does anybody know what the Greek word for witness is? Who said it? Awesome, Debbie. Martyr. Martyr. Martyr means witness in Greek. The Christian martyrs were witnesses. And they witnessed in whatever means was available, so long as it was in line with Christ. They witnessed in whatever means available, including through their own deaths. So the question for you is this. How are you witnessing to the resurrection, the truth of the resurrection? How are you witnessing to the fact that Christ is risen? How are you witnessing to the presence and the power of the Holy Spirit within you? And these questions beg an even more pressing question. Have you ever experienced the resurrected, living Lord in your life? Because quite frankly, you can't witness to something if you didn't witness it. Amen? You can't witness to something you have not experienced. So if we have not experienced the resurrected Lord in our lives, if we have not had a relationship with the one who died and was raised to life again, then it is going to be impossible for us to authentically witness to it. But if we have had that experience, if that is our experience, if that is what we know to be true, and if we do know the Lord and are in relationship with the Lord, then this is not just a hypothetical question, but a real question. Do you know the Lord Jesus Christ and have a relationship with him? This is not just a hypothetical. For Jesus is alive, amen? Jesus is risen, amen? He is in our midst and calling us to him, amen? Calling us to witness to others about him. That, as Jesus said in the gospel today, is our highest call as Christians. That, as Jesus said in the gospel today, we are witnesses to all these things. We are to witness to Christ's death, resurrection, and the forgiveness of sins to all who repent. We are the witness to the help, to the hope, the healing, and the wholeness that comes through Jesus Christ. We are the witnesses of the life and the teachings of Jesus as given to us through the gospel. We are the witnesses of the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ in our body called the church. Amen? As Jesus said, we are witnesses to all these things. And that is our charge as Christians, to be witnesses to the resurrected Christ and to make disciples of Jesus Christ of all people, in all places, throughout all time, so that one day, whether it be here on earth or in the new heaven that is to come on earth, all knees shall bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen? That is our call as Christians. Let us be witnesses to the gospel. Let us be witnesses to Jesus' death, his resurrection, and the life that comes through him. Amen. Let us pray. Gracious God, challenging God, thank you for challenging us and pushing us with this message. Thank you for reminding us what our call is as Christians. Help us to be effective witnesses for you. And Lord, for those who do not know you, those who do not have a relationship with you, here or beyond here in the world, we pray, Lord. We pray that they would come to know you and see you and the truth that lies in you and the life that lies in you. That through you they'd be able to find hope and healing and wholeness in their own lives. And through you they would grow in their faith and grow in their witness, so that your gospel and the kingdom that is to come would be fulfilled. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.